singing a selection of songs by Roger Quilter and Michael Head, so I shall tell you about the first three. Beginning with Weep You No More, Sad Fountains, which is from Quilter's Seven Elizabethan Lyrics. It's got a very melancholic feel, and I initially expected that it was going to be predominantly about weeping, but actually there's quite a lot of it about sleeping. Doth not the sunrise smiling when fair at e'en he set? I think most of us know how restorative a good night's sleep can be. After that, another Quilter song, Over the Land is April. This is a setting of a poem by Robert Louis Stevenson. The speaker is singing across the mountains to his lover, heralding the coming of the spring. This conjures up so many images for me, so I promise not to do any yodeling, at least not on purpose. A Green Cornfield by Michael Head is a setting of Christina Rossetti's words describing the sight and sound of a skylark while out walking. And if you haven't heard a skylark song before, I urge you to Google it and have a listen. There's a lovely kind of frilly piano motif that Head has written, and I think this is his interpretation of this very, very distinctive bird song.
Spring.
two more songs. The first one, another Quilter song, The Time of Roses. This is the reminiscence of an early lover's meeting when the roses were blooming. So much romantic poetry connects love with the warmth of spring and summer, and this beautiful poem by Thomas Hood is no exception, set so tenderly by Quilter. And my final song is Sweet Chance by Michael Head, text by William Henry Davis. And I wonder, perhaps this song doesn't really need an introduction. Like so many singers, I first learnt this song as a teenager, and I want to say it hasn't lost any of its charm since then. But in fact, I think I've found it more and more charming as the years have gone by.